This is Comedy Fight Club!
Egos will be wounded, feelings will be hurt, because we don't come here to make friends, we come here to fight! This is humiliation, this is brutality, anything goes, no holds barred, this is Comedy Fight Club! Thank you all for coming. Now, welcome to Comedy Fight Club, streaming on the Guest Digital Network every Wednesday night at 10:30, and coming to you live from the CFC Arena! I'm the official commissioner of Comedy Fight Club, the sleeveless wonder of the world, Matt Maron. Yeah, and we are on Twitter and Instagram at Comedy Fight NYC. Thanks to our social media hipster, give it up for Nico Pav. Yeah. We got a great show in store for you. Over 4 years now, we've been doing this every week. The best up-and-coming comedians in New York City will get on this stage. They're going to say the most mean, vicious, offensive, fucked up shit to each other, and no one's gonna get offended because we're all here to have a good time. Does that sound good, guys? Yeah. All right, we're gonna go to the rules here at Comedy Fight Club. Two fighters gonna get up on this stage. Every undercard battle, they're gonna go back and forth, tit for tat, for five jokes. Our main event's gonna be a three-round battle. We'll go over the rules for that when we get up to it. And the winners of these fights will be determined by our judges. Give it up for our judges. We're going to introduce them to you right now, but up first, not sitting at the judges' table over there, sitting in front of me right now, from this point forward, each and every single one of you is Comedy Fight Club, because your applause is going to count for one vote in each of these fights, which means I need you all to have a lot of fucking energy. You guys ready to help determine the winners of these fights? Yeah. One more time, I need the most energy you can ever muster up. Are you ready for judging these fights tonight? That's what I like to hear. Let's get to our judges over here up first. She's been on Comedy Central's Roast Battle on HBO Latina. Give it up for Kim Congdon.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much.
What's up, Kim? How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. I'm excited. It's going to be a fun night of battles. You've been on Comedy Central's Roast Battle. Do you have any advice for the fighters coming to the stage tonight?
You know, it really doesn't do much for you. So just have fun. Matt, I like your vest a lot.
Thank you.
This is, I guess, what happens when you give up on wrestling, huh?
Yeah. You still got cool vests. It comes with the job. Fight Club, give it up for Kim Congdon. And up next, former Roastmasters champion, one of the best roasters in New York City and in the world. Fight Club, give it up for Eli Sairs.
Thank you. Thanks, Matt.
What's up, Eli? How are you doing?
I'm doing good, man. Thanks for taking a break from tweeting at XFL players to be here.
Absolutely. XFL's greatest sport on television right now. Do you have any advice for the roasters coming up to the stage tonight?
Work hard, man. It really pays off. I'm talking like Kim Congdon might follow you on Twitter. It's fucking, it's been great for me.
Actually, last week, KP Burke was in the main event and spent his entire last joke saying that Kim doesn't follow him on Instagram.
Who is KP Burke?
Exactly. Fight Club. Give it up for Eli Sairs. And up next from High Society Radio on the Gas Digital Network, give it up for Chris from Brooklyn. Oh. What's up, Chris? How are you doing?
Well, I disagree with Kim. I think that vest makes you look like Stone Cold Steve Asshole.
I'll take it.
All right.
Do you have any advice for the roasters coming up to the station?
No, I never do. I mean, well, the first person diagnosed with coronavirus just got in Manhattan. Just escape. Run now. Don't even get on stage. Leave. We're dead.
We don't book Asian people. Everyone's fine.
Thank God. All right, we're good. This is a safe space, guys.
Yes. Fight Club, give it up for Chris from Brooklyn. And up next, she's one of the funniest comics in the city. Give it up for Wendi Starling.
Oh, thank you.
What's up, Wendi? How are you doing tonight? Your first time judging a Fight Club.
Yeah, that's my first time here. This is fun. I'm excited. I'm hungover from last night. I do. Your jacket, I like. I don't care about the sleeves. You have your full name written on that.
That's because no one knows it. Yeah.
I had brain surgery. I forget sometimes.
That's like asking to get molested. That's like the eternal. They're just like, Matt Maron, your mother told me to pick you up. Matt, get in the van.
A lot of the fight roasters coming up to the stage tonight. What can they do to stand out to you, Wendi?
This is going to come as be funny. I don't know. Be funny.
Remember when she made fun of me about my mom writing my name on my vest, guys? That was funny, right?
Yeah, do what I did 5 minutes ago, not what I did just now. You know what I mean? I'm showing a difference. That was funny.
Give it up for Wendi Starling. And up next, we got a full judges table tonight. She's been on Late Night with Stephen Colbert. Give it up for Katie Hanigan.
Yay. Woo, pew, pew, pew.
What's up, Katie?
Matt.
Also, your first time here judging. How are you feeling tonight?
I'm feeling like I wish we could squeeze a couple more fucking judges over here. Jesus Christ. Fucking Mike was like, we need you there, buddy. I was like, okay. But clearly, I could have fucking been home. I have to poop right now, so...
Katie, you were one of the best roasters on Roastmaster, one of the best roasters in New York. Do you have any advice for the fighters coming to the stage tonight?
Don't eat shit.
Don't eat shit. Fight Club, one more time. Give it up for Katie Hanigan. And our final judge tonight, he's been on Comedy Central's Roast Battle, also hosts Zac Amico's Midnight Spook Show on Gas Digital Network. Give it up for Zac Amico.
Thank you.
Zach, always fun having you here. How are you doing tonight?
Great. Matt, you're dressed like you should be walking me around on a leash.
Another one of the best roasters that we have. What advice do you have to the people coming up on stage tonight?
Be original. Don't do the same puns we've heard a million times. Find your cadence and stick it to them.
Fight Club, good solid advice. Give it up for Zac Amico. And now we have the officials of Comedy Fight. They've been with us since we started this show. They make the show what it is. Fight Club up first. It's our spirit animal, the always hyped Justin Lanza. And the official bishop of Comedy Fight Club, the king of the bits, the one, the lonely, Andrew Casertano. And finally, before we get started, we have to introduce our DJ. He's great. Give it up for DJ Charlottesville. What do you say, Fight Club? Are you ready to see some fights tonight? One more time, Fight Club. I said, are you ready to see some fucking fights tonight? Let's get this started. Your first battle, undercard matchup, scheduled 5 jokes, tit for tat. Introducing first, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, he looks like he masturbates to Tony Hawk's pro skater, Micah Walsh.
Who doesn't?
No music, DJ Charlottesville?
Better late than never.
How are you doing, Micah? You ready for this fight?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, we're going to meet your opponent now from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He's big into LARPing. He's a live-action retarded performer, David Piccolomini! What's up, David? How are you doing?
Oh, I'm great. I'm feeling full of the LARPing spirit.
Yes. Are you ready for this fight?
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Which one of you guys wants to go first?
All right,
Mike is going first. David's going second. It's five jokes, tip for tap, Fight Club. You ready for your first fight of the night? All right, this fight starts now.
All right, clap it up for my opponent, David. He's, believe it or not, he's used to getting claps. And by that, I mean he's had chlamydia twice. Not a joke. Applause breaks, he gets outbreaks, okay? Whatever, it's classic joke writing structure. I'm done with my time.
Any more? No? Okay, good. All right. Micah's ex broke up with him by moving to China. Apparently dating Micah is worse than the coronavirus.
That's a funny joke. I'm going to have to give it to you, bro. They didn't give it what it deserved, but good on you. They just like me personally better. David, this won't surprise anyone. He used to LARP. He used to be very into LARPing. You guys know what LARPing is? It's an acronym that stands for a lame-ass Renaissance perverts.
I like Matt's better, personally.
Oh, did he do a joke about that? I wasn't listening. fuck.
Micah failed ceramics and got fired from being a drug dealer. Basically, he's useless when it comes to pot.
Wait. I did not get fired from being a drug dealer, all right? I resigned. What does that even mean? I didn't get fired. I've been fired from so many jobs, but drug dealers, I've never had a boss. David is polyamorous, of course.
That's what the P in LARPing stands for.
No, actually, when I mean he's polyamorous, I mean he has sex with parrots, okay? All of your dads helped me write that joke.
Micah, just because you work at a pizza shop doesn't mean your jokes have to be cheesy. Micah's favorite vape flavor is a blend between Fruit Loops and Family Guy Season 1 DVD.
Yeah, keep it going for STDJ Qualls, everybody. David went to college for theater. Yeah, it's an old reference, fuckers. I'm old. You guys haven't seen The New Guy? David went to college for theater, and you can tell he's really good at acting like he has a comedy career.
High and inside. Okay. Micah got caught. Micah got caught stealing a Family Guy DVD, which is ironic because now he's a guy without family.
Last joke.
The joke is that my dad's dead. man, I had rebuttals planned for that, but I have a better last joke that I want to do instead. No,
well,
why would
I
do? I mean, my dad only died once, but you know, if your dad keeps relapsing, he's gonna meet my dad. I'm kidding. My dad's in heaven. All right, I do have one joke. I need this. I need to get my joke out though, or maybe I don't. Whatever. Oh yeah. Last year someone stole David's phone. This is true. Someone stole David's phone and they posted all the nudes that he had saved on his phone to his social media. And if you think that made David uncomfortable, imagine how the children in those photos felt.
They knew what they were getting into. No candy's free. Micah looks like Bart Simpson turned 30 and his dad died of lymphoma. Micah's dad had lymphoma and now Micah's got lymphomo. Fear of missing out on a life with his dad.
I miss him so much.
What a fucking first fight. Give it up for both of them. We'll start with you guys, Fight Club. Clap for one fighter and one. I didn't go over the most important rule of comedy, Fight Club. We'll do it right now. One fighter and one fighter only. You clap for only one, which leads me to the most important rule here at Comedy Fight Club.
No
No fucking pity claps.
No fucking pity claps. So we're going to ask you,
say
you
that. Hold on. You say that every week, and you forgot to say it until just now?
Yeah.
You need to write that on the vest.
I do, yeah, I do. I got to put that down there. Fight Club, do you think the winner of this fight is David Piccolomini? Oh.
Damn.
You guys understand the rule. I just said it.
They're just anti-LARPer. That's all it is. It's an anti-LARPer
crowd.
We'll
take this prejudice much longer.
Or is the winner of this fight Micah Walsh?
I get it. His dad's dead. Fine.
One vote for Micah. We'll go to our judge. We'll start with Kim Condon. What do you think of this fight?
And now for seven people to say the exact same thing. Great booking.
You know, I didn't. I think it was actually really close. Really close. Is your name Michael or Micah? Micah. Ugh. Yeah, I think that you guys did great, David. You're polyamorous, and my question is, with who? that is crazy. What, do you have a girlfriend with schizophrenia or something?
A lot of polyamorous people are schizophrenic.
Yeah, there's something there. I think that, Micah, you look like you say gee golly when you come. But I honestly think that you won the battle, but just by a thinning hair.
Two votes for Micah Walsh. Eli Sairs.
Great battle. You're both great. You both look like retards who don't have the strength to pet a bunny to death. David, you did good, but I clapped for you. That was a lie. I thought Micah won.
It's another vote for Micah Walsh. Chris from Brooklyn.
I feel like I just watched Micah be really mad about the idea of David's student loans being forgiven. I'm just going to give it to David because nobody has yet, you know?
That's one vote for David.
That's usually how I get it.
Three votes for Micah. Wendi Starling.
You guys are both great. I think you obviously won. I was shocked because I thought, David, you came out, but I thought you were going to kill. Honestly, mostly because you're dressed like you just got back from burying a body in a field. It's a blood stain on your jeans.
It's another vote for Micah Walsh. Katie Hanigan.
I felt like I was watching a battle between who had the worst haircut, honestly. Micah, you did good, but you also bombed a lot. I'll say that. Like, thank God your dad is dead, you know? But am I supposed to vote? That doesn't make any fucking
Micah's
sense.
Micah's got it sewn up at this point.
I vote for neither.
Okay. Micah's got it wrapped up, but Zac Amico, what did you think of the fight?
Guys, no fucking around. You guys just set the bar for the rest of the night. You guys were both really funny, and David, I don't want you to get discouraged because sometimes you just face somebody who's got a hot streak and they have a great night. You're really fucking funny, too. Good for the both of you, and good luck to all you fuckers back there that got to beat that.
Winner of this fight is Micah Walsh. Oh, we're nowhere near done. We got more fights. Fight Club, you ready for more fights? All right, up next, introducing first from Baltimore, Maryland. He runs a comedy show called Life's Good, and growing up in Baltimore, he ran from the police. Miles Toe! What's up, Miles? How are you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Good. You ready for this fight?
Yeah.
All right, we're going to meet your opponent now. From Brooklyn, New York, he looks like he made a pact to lose his virginity at prom and still hasn't. Joe Levy!
Hello. That's true.
Yo, I love Jimmy Neutron, dude.
Thank you.
Yeah, you guys look like you should switch hair.
What's up? Which one of you guys wants to go first?
I'll go first.
All right, Joe's going first. Miles going second. Your second fight of the night, Fight Club. Are you ready for this fight? Five jokes, tit for tat. This fight starts now.
Miles, Miles is a bipolar bisexual, which means he feels on top of the world on Monday and like a bottom on Tuesday.
Jesus fuck. Okay. Joe Levy, or as girls know him as Joe, please leave me alone, is a virgin. Last time Joe had sex was when his rabbi spit in his dick before he circumcised him.
First blood.
Thank you, black butt face. It is. Look harder. Look harder. Miles loves cocaine, sucking dick, and stinks at comedy. Who knew Miles is such a white girl?
Joe Levy, you pathetic little weasel. You look like an autistic Johnny Bravo just got kicked out of Hebrew school.
I had good grades. Miles was molested as a kid. It's funny. But he overcame it. And he moved to New York with nothing but his car, his clothes, and really repressed memories. That's funny.
Everyone's just sad. Joe Levy's 19 years old, so he had to get a fake ID. It's not because he's too young, it's because his real ID was just a Jewish star sewn in his coat.
Miles has a scar on his head, just like Harry Potter, which explains why he spent most of his life hiding in the closet.
Joe, you look like Peter Parker, but instead of getting bit by a spider, you got molested by Uncle Ben.
I could use the action, honestly. Miles is so dark, he was actually in 12 Years a Slave. As the rape scene.
All right. Joe wears pants so tight, they make him look like he power walked out of a concentration camp.
Last joke.
Wasn't that five?
No, it's yours. You're level one.
Oh, wait. Miles was molested by a gay man and is now a gay man. Hey, Miles, was he also wearing blackface?
That's your sister. Is that it? All right.
I should have said last joke, one joke sooner, I know. We'll go to our judges. Zac Amico, we'll start with you. What do you think of this fight?
This looks like Butthead tried to make his first black friend. Miles, congratulations. I never met a guy before with a 45-degree angle hairline. You guys are both funny. You guys do a great job up here. I'm happy for both of you. Miles, you fucking won, buddy.
One vote for Miles Toe.
Yeah.
Katie Hanigan.
Yeah, you guys did a great job. As a white woman, I felt offended by the racial tension. I have to say that legally. But Miles, yeah, good job. Good job, buddy.
Two votes for Miles Toe. Wendi Starling.
You guys are both great. Good job. Miles, you won. I do want to say it was weird because, Joe, you said, like, oh, Miles is hiding in the closet a bunch of times. But with those shoes, like, no, he's not. It's very obvious.
Three votes for Miles. We're going to go to you guys now. Fight Club, do you think the winner of this fight is Joe Levy? Or is the winner of this fight Miles Toe? Crowd vote goes to Miles. Chris from Brooklyn, what do you think?
Did all your Jewish comedy writers go on strike because you weren't paying them well, and then they work for the black guy now? Is that?
No.
That's not what happened. It does kind of also look like you want your wife, you want to be cuckolded, but you didn't want one that was too scary. That's how. He clearly was the bull in the situation, and really took charge. You lost there, Joe.
It's another vote for Miles, so he's got it wrapped up. But Eli Sairs, what do you think of the fight?
Fun stuff. Joe, you look like what Pete Buttigieg thinks a rebel looks like. Good job, Miles beat you badly.
Final thoughts from Kim Congdon.
That was fun, you guys. Fuck. You know, honestly, the stage right now looks like if you just put whatever into Pornhub. This was a good battle, you guys. But honestly, this isn't the first time you've battled. Battle between you guys has been centuries old, huh?
No, it's just as the Crown Heights riots in the 80s.
All right, I don't want to take too long. Joe's got to get back to saying the N-word on TikTok. But Miles, congratulations on your win.
Winner of this fight is Miles Toe. Two fights down. We got two more undercards, then a main event fight club. Are you ready for more fights? All right, up next, another undercard battle. Introducing first, from Los Angeles, California. He looks like he made a sex robot that likes nice guys. Ethan Victor!
Well, how's it going? What's up?
What's up, Ethan? How are you doing?
I'm good, you know?
You ready for this fight?
Absolutely. Ready to never grow up, you know? Yeah.
We're going to meet your opponent now. From Danbury, Connecticut, she looks like if a pair of Ugg boots were a person, Claire Alexander!
What's up?
What's up, Claire? How are you doing?
I'm feeling pretty good. I want to fuck my opponent, so... Yeah, that's where I'm at.
Hot start. Which one of you guys wants to go first?
I'll go first.
All right, Claire's going first. Ethan's going second. Fight Club, are you ready for this fight? Five jokes, tip for tat. This fight starts now.
All right, Ethan's mom still dresses him, and that's because he's scared if he opens his closet, he might come out.
Yeah. Claire and I have a few things in common. We both never come, and both have tried to suck my dick.
Excellent. Yeah. Failed. If only. Thanks, handsome. Ethan looks like he picks his nose but doesn't eat it because he thinks he's allergic.
Damn, I have many allergies. Yeah. Claire has such theater kid energy, she calls foreplay Act One, opening the beef curtain.
It's true, yeah, here it comes. The only time Ethan brings a girl home with him is when he asks her to walk him home because he's too nervous to go by himself.
She tried to fuck me a lot, you know?
Yeah.
Claire's least favorite position is the least gentrification. That's where a bunch of black dudes move into her asshole.
Ethan is a lactose intolerant Jew. What's it like to be able to control the weather but not your bowels?
The only thing we've ever done is letting me shit on her chest. That's the only, it's, all right. Claire's dad pays her rent, which means there's no reason for her to have sucked 525,600 dicks.
That's good. What, my dad?
Last joke.
He loves me. All right. Ethan told me once he would never do improv, and I thought he should reconsider because that's the only time he could make a girl say yes and.
I said no to you a lot again. We all know Claire doesn't actually want to fuck me because she's racist and my penis isn't wearing its white hood.
We'll go to our judges' table. We'll start this time with Kim Condon. What did you think after this fight?
That was really fun. It's very confusing because it looks like neither of you would want to fuck each other. Claire, you look like you would eat Ethan's pussy. Yeah. Ethan, I thought your jokes were really good, but I'm honestly offended. Like, why can't you suck dick if your parents pay your rent? Oh, okay. Never mind. oh, okay. Oh, they pay her rent. Oh, okay.
Just this month, though, I swear. I'm cool.
But you're doing it all wrong, honestly. The meaner you are, the more she's going to want to fuck you. I don't know who to vote for because I kept trying to make a Blue's Clues joke about you. So I'm going to withdraw my vote this time.
One abstaining vote. Eli Sairs, what do you say?
Good stuff. I'm sorry, what's the girl's name?
Claire.
No, the other girl.
Ethan.
Matt Maron. It's Matt Maron. That's
it's on his vest.
Good stuff.
My pronouns are going to be printed on next week.
Wait, do you mean the bull dyke or Claire?
Good stuff. I'm going to give it to Never Been Banged Theory.
One vote for Ethan Victor. Chris from Brooklyn.
The only thing I really have to say about this battle is I think you're really going to be creepy to her when she starts dating somebody else. Like, we all have seen this happen in every college, right? Like, that's... Okay. You won, though, I guess. Yeah. All right. Congrats.
Two votes for Ethan Victor. Fight Club, we're going to go to you guys now. Do you think the winner of this fight is Ethan Victor? Or do you think the winner of this fight is Claire Alexander?
They are so mad about Elizabeth Warren.
Close, but it looks like crowd vote goes to Claire Alexander. It's 2-1 right now. Wendi Starling, what do you think?
This is tough because, Claire, I really love that just out of the gate, you sexually harassed him immediately. It was not nice. She was like, I'm trying to fuck this guy. So I appreciate that. I think, Ethan, your jokes were a little bit stronger, so I'm going to vote for Ethan. But I do want to clarify, she's not trying to have sex with you. She mistook you for a super slim tampon. Oh. She's just trying to get you. That's...
Three votes for Ethan, one for Claire. Katie Hanigan, what do you
that,
say?
I think that don't try to fuck Woody Allen because he's fucking his own kids. Claire, we get it. You have low self-esteem. Keep sucking dick, girl. Get out there. Do the Lord's work. You had some good jokes. But I would say Ethan had a couple extra good jokes. Couple more.
Another vote for Ethan Victor. He's got it wrapped up. But Zac Amico, what do you think?
Everything's coming up Milhouse. Ethan. you guys were both great. Ethan, your shit was a little bit stronger, and you had some really good comebacks. I'm going Ethan on this one.
Winner of this fight is Ethan Victor. We got one more undercard fight before our main event fight club. You ready for more fights? Yeah. Final undercard fight of the night. Introducing first from Glen Rock, New Jersey. For him, consent is a red flag. It's Dan Polzello. A lot of child molestation jokes, and now mustache. What's up?
You get what you pay for, guys.
How are you doing, Dan?
I'm good.
Good. Real, you ready for this fight?
Oh, yeah. Real ready.
All right. We're going to meet your opponent now from Queens, New York. She broke her hymen on a bike the time a Hell's Angel raped her. Natalie Cuomo! What's up, Natalie? How are you doing?
I kind of want to puke, but I think Dan would like that too much.
You guys ready for this fight? Which one of you wants to go first?
Ladies first.
All right, thank you. Sounds good.
All right, Natalie's very confidently going first. It's going to be 5 jokes, tit for tat, starting with Natalie. Fight Club, you ready for your final undercard fight of the night? All right, this fight starts now.
Hey, Dan, remember the last time we hung out? I don't, because you roofied me. Roofies are the one thing Dan's parents didn't know they were paying for in college.
All right, thank you, fentanyl bender Barbie. But Natalie is very beautiful. She clearly has a smile that can light up a needle exchange.
Get over here!
Dan is hot enough to be convicted of rape, but he's not hot enough to make a headline.
So this is true. Natalie is an actor. Her boyfriend makes her act like she got those bruises falling down the stairs.
Shots fired! Shots fired!
Ethan lives at home, and his mom is a pediatric oncologist. So that just means his mom would rather watch kids die than spend time with him at home.
So Natalie is she's tatted, she's tatted up, and she's Jewish. So that means she comes from a long line of people with regrettable arm tattoos.
Dan, he makes a lot of jokes about his dad being fat, and it's just a really cute way of accepting that soon he's gonna look like Zac Amico.
Natalie, you look like Frankenstein if it were made of girls that got kidnapped on spring break.
Last
okay,
joke.
Dan's life sucks. He's got a lot of holes to fill. His girlfriend does too, and that's why she fucked his entire lacrosse team.
So here's the thing. Natalie's body's covered in tattoos, but I need you guys to know she didn't get the tattoos for you, okay? They're not for you. They're for the guy who is doing her overdose autopsy. And that's it.
Remember the first three jokes of that battle, guys?
That was fun.
We're going to go to our judges. We'll start with Chris from Brooklyn. What do you think of this fight?
I think that every time I look at this stage, I'm furious that my rent is so fucking high. Angry. I hate you both. You both lose. Goodbye.
One abstaining vote. Wendi Starling.
You guys are both funny. I'm gonna give it to Natalie. I feel like you had stronger jokes. But I want to give you kudos. What's your name again? Dan?
Dan.
I'm sorry. I was distracted by all the stuff in your pockets. You've got... there's so many things. So many. And nary a dick print. So you might want to...
Yeah, this
one
felt
vote
like a shitty improv show, I have to say. Like you guys,
as opposed to all those great improv shows.
You guys should be in a troupe together. Now, I'll give it to Natalie. I thought you had a couple stronger jokes. And, maybe this also could be a sitcom where Dan's a rapist. I don't know. I'm just spitballing here. Just spitballing.
Two votes for Natalie. Zac Amico.
Both very funny, and I like you a lot. People don't know who I am yet, but... they've been listening to me, but they don't know who I am. It's okay. Good try. You're both very funny. I thought Natalie had stronger overall, but Dan had bigger hits, and he got bigger laughs. So I'm going to go with Dan on this one.
So it's two votes for Natalie, one vote for Dan. We're going to go to you guys now. Fight Club, do you think the winner of this fight is Natalie Cuomo? Or is the winner of this fight Dan Pulzello? It's pretty close. Looking at it, it's like barely Dan, I think. We'll go to the rest of our judges. Kim Condon, what do you think of this fight?
It's so fucking close, you guys. You both did really great. Dan's got to get back to hiding in a ball pit at McDonald's. And Natalie, I don't know why, but you look like you order chicken tenders everywhere you go. It was a really close battle. The thing that really fucked me up about this battle is she was like, Dan roofied me, and we were all like, ha ha, next joke. But because I kind of believe it. Dan looks like he'd eat you out before he raped you.
And after.
Well, that's just because he's hungry after. Really close battle, but really, really, really close. I'm going to give it to Dan.
It's another vote for Dan. It's 3-2 right now in favor of Dan. Eli Sairs, what do you say?
Good battle, Dan. Good stuff. You somehow look like Freddie Mercury and a homophobe. a little bit interesting. I'm going to slightly give it to Natalie.
Tied 3-3. Chris from Brooklyn, you abstained. Can you break the tie for us?
I kind of agreed with Zach's points that I thought Dan had bigger hits. I thought maybe it was a little more overall, but I thought Dan had bigger laughs throughout, like the first three. It seemed like you guys both ran out of steam towards the end, but it took him a little longer to do so because he's way more steampunk than you. That's the whole. But yes, I'll give it to Dan, actually.
So very close battle. The winner of this fight is Dan Pulzello.
Ha ha ha!
And now, Fight Club, it's time for party time with our spirit animal. Give it up for Justin Lanza.
All right. Comedy Fight Club, how you guys doing? Is everybody having fun out there? Make some noise if you're having some fun out there. Come on. Let me hear you. Oh, my God. Oh, yes. You know what they say in show business? Save the hottest for last. You two look like you would only fuck if there was a mirror between you. I like that you're both so gay, you're wearing the same, like, bi-gender dumb boots. Did you notice Dan's boots have no laces so that when he bends over, there's no open invitation for dudes to fuck him in the ass? Ooh, that was a little too on the nose. Lesson learned. I'll dial it back for you guys. How about a shout out to the first fight of the night? That was Dan Piccolo meeting Michael Walsh. You want that here? Pretty strong, yeah. Fight between the two strongest of the beta males. Winner gets to smell our lady judge's hair.
Watch the show. Oh my God.
I'm gonna fucking rock. I'm gonna get a little more noise for what's his name? You'll see your best. Oh, that's Mr. Matt Merritt! Spirit animal, Justin Lanza! Now it is time for our main event of the
evening! It's gonna be a three-round battle. First round's gonna be four jokes, tit for tat. Second round is four jokes straight through. Third round's another four jokes, tit for tat. We'll go to our judges in between rounds for feedback, but we're gonna pick a winner at the end overall after all three rounds. So one more time, Fight Club, are you ready for your main event tonight? All right, introducing first from Atherton, California. He can do an impression of anything except a likable comedian, Robbie Goodwin!
How we doing there, Matt?
What's up, Robbie? How are you doing?
I'm good. I just got off, much like Tom, I just got off my job at 7-Eleven, and I'm open Hillary Clinton. I was looking for interns. I'm gonna eat Hillary Clinton's pussy, everybody.
You're looking a little different than normal, Robbie. You look a little like your opponent tonight.
Yeah, you should have introduced him first. This gag makes no sense when you introduce me first. You fucking idiot, Matt. God damn it. You're the most retarded person I'm gonna share a stage with tonight. God damn it. Fucking idiot. God damn it. Oh, wow, he dressed up, but introduce him first. Nobody's gonna get it. God damn it, Matt. I hate you so much. But
we're gonna meet your opponent. From Baltimore, Maryland, the only thing that Comptown talks about that isn't funny, Tom Myers! Tom Myers. Now you guys see it?
Yeah, really funny now, huh? We all love hindsight comedy.
Mom makes me bring him with me when I go on my dates.
Yeah. Tom tried that out in the hallway.
And comedy? Tattles.
Which one of you guys wants to go first in round one?
I'll go.
Tom's going to go first. Robbie's going second. It's your main event. Are you ready for the main event? Four jokes, tip for tat. This fight starts now.
Robbie Goodwin is from San Francisco, which is fitting because whenever someone asks him, how did you get booked on this show, or how did your set go, his answer to both is the same. I ate dick.
Damn, Tom, I don't know how I'm going to come back from that. fuck, I don't have anything that good. God damn it, Tom. It's good to be here roasting Pennywise with coronavirus. Hate to tell you this, Tom, but you're a bit of a clown.
Uh, Robbie Goodwin was born in 1992. They started giving out condoms in schools in 1993. Now you know why.
Shots fired! Shots fired! Shots fired indeed. My parents weren't in school when they fucked, Tom. Tom is pretty well known online because of Cumtown. For those of you that don't know, Cumtown is Tom's asshole. I like my wife. Tom doesn't have one.
No wife, no wife, no wife, no wife, no wife.
Hey, Robbie, my jokes bought me a new truck. Your jokes make your audience wish you would suck on the exhaust of one.
Damn, Tom, your jokes bought you a truck? That's cool.
No wife, no wife, no wife,
that's what I said.
No.
That's my wife. Tom is from Baltimore, but has never seen The Wire, unless you count the one his dad used to try and abort him. Nice.
Give it up for round one of your main event. Killer battle. You can judge. We'll go to our judges. You can say who you think is winning so far. We're going to pick a winner overall at the end. But so far, Kim Condon, what do you think after round
one? Holy fuck, that hurt my feelings. That was insane. Tom, you look like what Louis C.K. feels like now.
Louis C. works at Kmart.
It was really good. I think Robbie Goodwin always brings the energy. You're like if cocaine was a person. So I think that... I honestly, I don't know. Tom, did you fax your jokes to yourself?
I bought the new truck. I forgot to pay my phone bill.
Tom Myers.
I feel like every time Tom texts you, there's a signature at the end. It was really fun.
Eli Sairs.
Oh shit, you're dressed like him. that was fun stuff. Tom, you somehow look like a homeless CEO. Dead even.
Chris from Brooklyn.
Robbie, I just... They had to bring in a ringer to find someone less likable than you. And then you dressed up like that guy. I'm going to give it to Tom Myers.
Wendi Starling.
Okay, I'm going to give that round to Robbie. But Tom, I do give it up for Tom for coming all the way out here. It was nice that we were able to make it from a cruise ship in 1987. Thank you so much for being here. But Robbie, it is nice that you're like, you are very comforting up there and you look like you have a knife on your person. It's fucking terrifying.
Katie Hanigan.
Yeah, Tom looks like he's getting ready for a business interview to molest someone. Man, I'm fucking bombing over here. Sorry, everybody. I'm spiraling as a judge. Fuck all of you, okay? Yeah, Robbie, obviously incredible. Tom, very bad.
You sound like my last date.
Shut the fuck up.
Zac Amico. Oh,
but that's his life. Robbie Goodwin, and I mean this in all sincerity, there is no better forum for your horse shit comedy. than this show. Hey, guys, keep the hits coming.
Fight Club, we're going to go to round two. Are you ready for round two of the main event? Before joke straight through, we're going to start with Robbie Goodwin. Round two starts now.
Round two. Fight. Tom had a small role on House of Cards. He was brought in to make Kevin Spacey look like less of a pedophile.
he fucks kids even more than me. Tom has a side job announcing youth baseball. He's also the only announcer that showers with the kids afterwards. Tom's dream is to win an award for acting, but the only time he'll hear Oscar and Myers together is when he's selling hot dogs at 7-Eleven.
One more.
I call Tom's career River Phoenix because it's 22 years old, delusional, and long dead. He's the Joker's brother, everybody. That's
Tom Myers.
I don't want to say Robbie Goodwin is not a ladies' man, but he considers a threesome using both hands when he masturbates. In high school, Robbie Goodwin was voted most likely to be catfished. Whenever Robbie Goodwin looks in the mirror, he automatically swipes left.
One more.
Guys, if you're here, you know, you're alone, you're by yourself, you're nervous, you feel awkward, you have low self-esteem, and you're not good at talking to women, just know that you have a better chance of getting a blowjob than Robbie Goodwin. And of course, that's by Robbie Goodwin.
I just got annihilated, I think.
Oh, you'll be fine.
Fight Club, give it up for round two of your main event.
Go to our judge, Wendi Starling. We'll start with you. What do you think after round two?
I thought the both were really great. I'm actually going to give that to Tom because I thought, Tom, your jokes were really solid. And Rob, you're so funny with the comebacks. But I also want to say I still love you because I just realized watching that battle, watching your body language, Joaquin Phoenix, when he did the Joker, was like based on you. Like that was just terrifying.
You would say that, Mary.
He has a weapon. Yeah.
Katie Hanigan.
No, I would say I agree. I thought Tom and his joke truck brought it back around. I'm going to give it to you.
Zac Amico.
I mean, what can I say with a barrage like that? You got massacred, bro. It's all Tom.
Kim Congdon.
Oh, that was refreshing as fuck. This is like when an abused husband stands up to his wife. You really brought it back, Tom. Good job.
Eli Sairs. Robbie, I'm annoyed that I enjoy you. Tom, you look like you're bullied by your son.
Chris from Brooklyn.
Tom looks like the announcer in his weird King of Comedy Tonight Show fantasy, right? It's the Joker. It was the Joker 30 years ago, all right? Fuck you guys. Yeah. I think Tom is still kicking your ass, though, Rob. You suck.
Fight Club, we're going to round three. One more round of your main event. Are you ready to find out who is the winner? We're going to start with Tom, four jokes, tit for tat. Round three starts now.
Robbie Goodwin uses a song sung by Bill Cosby as the theme tune for his podcast. It's fitting, seeing as he looks like the ad campaign about the dangers of leaving your drinks unattended.
Thank you, Tom. Good one, Tom. That was a good joke. You nailed me. Tom looks like a Coen Brothers character. Particularly Steve Buscemi if he died.
Robbie Goodwin looks like his picture should be on one of those ads on diner placemats that say, "We buy houses in any condition," so he can store dead children in his basement.
God damn, Tom, you're fucking killing me. Tom performed at Gilda Radner's Laugh Fest. He was booked so people could know what Gilda felt when she died painfully of cancer. Yeah, take that, Tom! I'm coming back!
Robbie, I love how you go ahead and tag jokes with even worse ones. You sound like one of those TV pitchmen who try and attach a free product to something that people don't even need to buy. And that's not all. Order right now, and I'll give you a shittier joke absolutely free.
Tom! 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 Tom!
Tom. I hope you win, dude, honestly. I'm fucking dying, man. Jesus Christ.
Somewhere, Nick Mullen is crying in a giant pile of money.
And Stav is laughing all the way to the bank. Tom Myers has been an extra on Veep, House of Cards, and in his bedroom while his girlfriend fucks a belt. God damn it, Tom. You got in my head. You psyched me out. All right. Fuck. All right. Well, Tom, all right. Oh, no, it's haunted in here. Fuck off. Jesus Christ. Boo, shut up.
Stop, you guys. He's going to kill us.
Yeah, I'm going to joke her out, bitches, if you don't settle down. All right, you want me to do it? It's not going to do well now. All right. Okay, all right. Thank you. I like how I'm spiraling more than Tom. God damn it. All right. Tom has been an extra on Veep, House of Cards, and in his bedroom while his girlfriend fucks a black guy. Just kidding, Tom lives with his parents and has never had sex.
Last joke.
There we go.
I want to thank the audience for coming out tonight, The Stand for hosting us, and Cumtown fans on Reddit for writing all of Robbie's jokes. Yeah. Only joking, of course, Robbie, only joking. The Cumtown fans on Reddit write much funnier stuff than you. Yeah.
They mostly just call me a faggot, but that's fine. Tom has a joke where he says he looks like Ellen DeGeneres. Tom, no one would ever think you're Ellen DeGeneres. Ellen DeGeneres gets pussy.
Fight Club, give it up for both of your main eventers in the fight that they just gave you.
We'll go to our judges. We'll start with Zac Amico. Who do you think is the winner of our main event?
You know, Robbie, I know you like to come up here dressed as other comedians. It's nice to see you change that up tonight. Listen, you both did great. Everybody had a wonderful time, but I think Robbie's first round carried him to a victory. That was, he just fucking was so solid up top. Fell apart a little at the end, but still consistently funny.
That's one vote for Robbie Goodwin. Katie Hanigan.
I love Robbie now. It's hard to tell, like, if you have brilliant stage presence or if you're autistic. But both. I think I'm a fan. I'm a fan. And I don't like that other guy.
Two votes for Robbie. Wendi Starling.
I really was hoping Tom would pull it out so you could buy pants that fit. It looks like he shrunk. You know what I mean? But Robbie, like, you're great. That was great. Give it
another
to Robbie.
Another vote for Robbie. We're going to go to you guys. Fight Club. Do you think the winner of this fight is Tom Myers?
Tom.
Or do you think the winner of this fight is Robbie Goodwin? Pretty close. The chant may have put it over the top, but we'll go to the rest of our judges. Chris from Brooklyn.
If Tom wins, does he get a suit that's all one color? I'm asking you a question, Matt Maron.
No, I'll paint his name on it for him.
No?
Though.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna give it to Gary Oldman from The Fifth Element then.
Another vote for Robbie Goodwin. Eli Sairs. Fun battle. Tom, you look like Louis C.K. ran out of cum. You look like you lost half your punchlines in the divorce. I think that Robbie kind of like flubbed at the end and Tom kept his composure. I'm going to throw it to Tom.
This one vote for Tom Myers. We already have four for Robbie. So Robbie's the winner. But Kim Condon, what are your final thoughts on the fight?
It was a great fight. Tom, that was incredible how you brought it back. I don't know. I have nothing. You killed it. I hope that you are just as successful as Kobe Bryant. What?
Ari Shaffir, is that you?
Winner of this fight is Robbie Goodwin!
Tom's already older than Kobe Bryant.
That's true. Can we cut that last joke out of the internet?
Sure. What, have you gotten in trouble on the internet for a Kobe joke recently?
Oops.
Fight Club, it's time for the Bishop's Address. You guys got to give it up for our Bishop, the King of the Bits. Give it up for Andrew Casertano!
Bits, 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 bits.
Yeah, one more time for Matt Maron, you guys. How you guys doing? Keep it going for my boy Chris, everyone. He took time off from being my boy to judge here tonight. Chris tried to roast me once. Do you remember that? You were feeling overwhelmed by my bits, so your final joke, you hit my tit, and just like that, we're not boys anymore. You just love walking around Park Slope with your big, beautiful sausage arms. You hurt me that night. I want revenge. Take care of him, Zach. I want you to power slam my boy. You guys like wrestling, right? That's how you spend your Saturday nights with each other. You think I'm jealous of you watching other men roll around? Ooh. Kim Congdon is here tonight. Woo! Yeah. I had a chance to talk to her earlier. How'd you do, Andrew? Did you win her heart yet? Nope. She told me to come to a fighting class, and I told her that I was a pussy. Woo! Kim, just face it. You can protect me. Okay. There's so many judges here tonight. Let them hear it. Yeah, I respect all of you, but have you guys ever really seen me thrust my hips before? Yeah, ooh. Yeah, ooh. The stand likes my body. Okay, let's see. Yeah. Let's Kegel. You guys want to Kegel with me? All right. After the fight, Zach gave a speech about how the first fight set the tone. He said good luck to the other fighters as if they needed it. Dude, this is Comedy Fight Club. We came here to fight. My next opponent, I will make come. Okay. Claire versus Ethan. Claire opened the fight by saying she wants to fuck Ethan. Ooh, I'm so jealous. Ethan is a hunk. He deserves you. Ooh, I'm 35. I want to watch you two have sex. Who cares? So what? I'm breaking down. Protect me, Kim. Okay. Dan versus Natalie. This was a hard fight. The whole time I was watching, I was like, I want to know who I want to fuck, but maybe it's you, Dan. Teach me lacrosse. I can't protect a woman. I hate myself. All right, guys, that's it for me. Thank you.
The Bishop, Andrew Casertano. Thank you guys for coming out. The show streams every Wednesday night on Gas Digital. Download the podcast wherever you guys get podcasts. Give it up one more time for all the fighters you saw tonight. All of our judges, our DJ producer, Mike Harrington. Thank you guys very much. Have a good night.